So if the diagnosis of moyamoya is made, and if folks are in agreement that surgery is probably the right thing, we usually have sort of a common set of steps that we go through here. We'll make sure that we review the images with the family, make sure we have a group discussion amongst the various physicians here, the radiologists, the neurologists, the neurosurgeons, the interventional radiologists, all the different team members, to make sure we're happy with the diagnosis and we have a plan. If moyamoya is seen, we usually say that surgery is the right treatment. There are many different kinds of surgery. In children, there's evidence to suggest that what's called an indirect bypass, allowing blood vessels to grow with the child, is usually the best treatment. Not always, but usually. And there are other kinds of surgeries that are done that can help. But at the end of the day, all the surgeries are designed to bring healthy blood supply, usually from outside the skull, in the skin or in the muscle, to the brain, because there's a wall of the skull that prevents the healthy blood that isn't affected by moyamoya outside from getting inside. So the surgeon's job is to create that connection between the healthy blood outside and getting to where it's needed inside. So that's the idea behind surgery. Overall, the surgery is really the most successful way to reduce the risk of stroke. And what we've shown with our surgical series here at Boston Children's is that we can take that 5-year risk of stroke, that 66 to 90% risk of stroke, and knock it down to about 4 to 4.5%. So while it's not perfect, it's a darn sight better than what would happen if you just left things alone. And our hope is that by using surgery in a thoughtful way, in appropriate patients, that we can really help these children live full and happy lives.